Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again. All right, I got a question to answer today, and I hope I can answer it, because it's merely my understanding. I can't tell you that it's an absolute, but from all of my research and my hundreds and hundreds of hours of viewing videos, especially the early ones and some of the more scientific ones, I think I have an answer. Okay. teacherz2 asked a question on one of my videos. I enjoy your vids, KB. However, I'm getting confused by the term rocket stove as used in some of the YouTube vids I've seen. Some incorporate a J-tube, some an L-tube. Perhaps the most confusing for me is that some incorporate a reburn chamber or an inverted barrel, old propane tank. It really doesn't reburn in that tank. That tank is just a heat collector. While others direct the exhaust gases straight out the top. My question is, what makes a rocket stove a rocket stove? Okay. Well, it goes back to this guy, Dr. Winiarski. And he designed a stove for third world countries where people had no money, or very little money, and they were burning wood on the ground. And of course, if you know you burn wood on the ground, it has to get its air from on top. Very, very inefficient way to burn. After a short period of time, the fire becomes just a smoldering pile of charcoal. Charcoal puts out a tremendous amount of carbon monoxide, and also in the burn, there's a lot of soot gases. And of course, it's tremendously inefficient. So it was burning up the forests and killing a lot of people by destroying their lungs and their health. So he said there had to be a better way. And so he figured the best way is to get air underneath and to make sure that the flame burned hot enough that it was complete combustion. You know, basically, what the theory of the catalytic converter on your car is that it provides a secondary burn that gets extremely hot to burn off any unburned hydrocarbons inside the internal combustion engine. A lot of that would be helped by a better fuel, but that's another video. Okay, so how this is accomplished? Well, first of all, it's accomplished by the air coming past the wood, not down on top of it, and passively, so you get an increased flow of air and an insulated burn chamber where it can concentrate the heat to the point where the fire burns, instead of around 900 or 1,000 degrees, we get up to close to 2,000 degrees in some cases, hot enough to melt aluminum in one of my videos. So that's where the rocket stove comes from, is that intense burn, insulated combustion that burns all the gases and all the carbon and everything extremely, extremely efficiently. In fact, if you put your finger in the exhaust of most of my rocket stoves and wipe it around, even if they've been burned 100, 200 times, you don't get soot. It's clean because it burns it all. So, he built this stove, and in building this stove, it made such a roar that he nicknamed it Rocket Stove. It is an open source technology. He didn't patent it. He didn't copyright it. He wanted everybody in the world to be able to use it. That's why I don't patent anything. I don't copyright anything. Everything I do is absolutely open source. That was his desire. That's my desire. Now, if I produce these things to sell, you know, I'll sell the finished product. But the technology is free. If you ask me how to do it, I'm going to tell you. In fact, most everything I do is that way, because I figure it this way. I fix cars for a living. I fix cars, trucks, bulldozers, road graders, everything. From the teeniest, tiniest little weed eater things up to the great big hugest backhoes and track loaders and whatever you see, I've worked on it. So I have a tremendous amount of experience in this area. Now, I can explain to you what I do, and you might be able to do it. But the likelihood is you probably can't. So it doesn't cost me anything to tell you how to do it. And if you can do it, that's fine. There's a whole bunch of other people out there that can't. So it's not hurting my business any to explain to somebody how to do something. And I don't believe in this problem of competition. It would be well if there were a dozen more good mechanics around this area, because they would compete perhaps with some of these super huge corporate things that have such a rip-off philosophy. So it doesn't hurt me any pass on technology, but that's where it is. Doesn't matter if it's going left, right, upside down, or otherwise. It has an insulated burn chamber and it burns completely. It is indeed a rocket stove. Now, rocket stove is a wood gasifier. There's no doubt about it. It allows the wood to burn from the end and backwards, so that the gases that come off burn as the wood is consumed. The wood gasifier stove is also a gasifier, so it burns a secondary burn. I wouldn't use either one of them inside the house. I mean, I have, but it stinks the house up for a long time because you have, you know, the incomplete combustion of getting it started and when it goes out. Both of them can stink pretty bad. But that's the rocket stove issue. A insulated combustion area that can get tremendously hot, and then whatever you do with the exhaust afterwards is really irrelevant. What direction you go. That was Winnie Arsky's big thing, was getting the temperature of the stove above normal combustion temperatures so that it burned efficiently enough so we didn't have carbon monoxide killing the people, we didn't have all that soot in the air killing the people, and it burns, I gotta say, like 98% efficiently. There's almost nothing left. There's no carbon left in the ashes at all. It's just ash. And most of the time, there's no smoke, there's no soot, there's no nothing. It's almost 100% complete combustion. The only losses that you have are if your chimney temperature is getting hot and you're sending heat out the chimney. That's why I build my stoves in such a manner that the flow is slower and most of the heat comes out my stove rather than going up the chimney. And some of my big burns this winter, when the temperature was real low, I do get some exhaust temperatures that are getting up there pretty good. But I prefer the exhaust to be cool to the touch if I can do it. Hope that answers your question, teachers, too. And if not, send me a response to this video, and I will be thoroughly happy to put another video up, because that's what I do. Ken Bacon. Bye.